what's up, dudes? Ha 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 ha. Anyways, intros are hard. Terrible skin here. I have a quick complaint. Gorillaz, as we all know, has just announced Song Machine as a full album. For those of you who don't know, Song Machine is this weird little project they've been doing where they've been dropping singles whenever they feel like it, as opposed to having some kind of set schedule. Most of these have actually really cool features. Unlike Humans, these features branch off of just modern hip-hop. We have St. Vincent is going to be announced, which is exciting. Elton John, a lot of cool features. However, with that, they have also just announced a multitude of record packages. A regular standard LP. Vinyl Me Please is doing a recycled pressing, which is great. If I were to nab one, I would do the recycled pressing just for environmentally friendly reasons. And a deluxe and super deluxe version. Similar to Humans, the super deluxe version is totally asinine. As you can see right here, there's a 2LP. But in addition to that, there are 11 7 inches. At least with the Human Super Deluxe version, all of the extra records, as wasteful as that was to have each song be on its own record, had an interesting B-side. The issue with this Super Deluxe version is that all of the A-sides are already the songs on the album. Cool. So, when I spend $250 on this Super Deluxe package, I get every song on the album twice. Awesome. What on earth were they thinking with this? Not only is this just a waste of vinyl, but I'm not getting anything more out of this super deluxe version than I would if I just bought the regular deluxe version. I get that instrumentals are cool, but if you care enough about the instrumentals to spend an extra like $200, what are you doing? Yeah, look here. Regular deluxe version is just the 2LP and the CD. That's perfect. I don't need anything more than that. Yeah, second LP comes with the B-sides. Wow, comes with a bunch of prints and stuff too. Oh, I guess it comes with an art book. But even still, so did Human Super Deluxe, and that art book looked boring as all hell. And some of the Song Machine singles have been interesting, but not enough that I want to own all of them twice in one box set. Kindle Music Box. The Song Machine theme song. Okay, that's kind of cool. The theme song isn't actually included on the album. Besides that, totally pointless. I get it too. Artists are dropping a lot of physical stuff right now because that's the only way they can make money with the pandemic going on. I totally get that and I support that. However, how about giving us a box set that isn't full of redundancies or literally the same thing twice? As stupid as Joji's new merch is, at least it's not this, right? He just released a 2LP and some awful looking merch. That was it. They're literally trying to sell us multiple of the same thing. Oh my god, and just looking at their site, I just realized too. Cassette tapes, each in different colors. So you can buy the album 4 times if you're a hoarder and have it be different colors. Listen, I'm not one to talk necessarily. I have multiples of stuff that I love. But usually I make sure that it's an album that's full of good music. Like, I own multiple copies of Amnesiac because I love that album enough to have it tattooed on me. I can't get a good angle on that. Look at it. Can we also talk about how cassette tapes these days are more expensive than CDs? I can see through your hipster bullshit. Cassettes are the worst sound quality out of the 3 main physical versions you can buy of an album. This cassette tape should not be $20 and the CD is like $15 or whatever. Just because Urban Outfitters tells you it's limited edition and that you need to own it does not mean that the sound quality is going to be magically more interesting. Ironically, CDs have the best sound quality out of record CDs and cassette tapes. It doesn't get much better than just the actual digital version. Yeah, records have warrants and you can customize the sound based on setup. That doesn't matter. CDs are technically the best. Don't pay too much money for tape hiss and like having to rewind it too much. Again, I might sound hypocritical. I own cassette tapes of albums that I love, but those are albums that I love. This here, though, is more than supporting the artist. They're just milking it. They're using you. Sorry, Damon, but I'm not gonna buy 4 different versions of this album. Especially with the Gorillaz, like, track record lately, you know what I mean? Like, no offense, but... I already know that the majority of these Song Machine songs are not that interesting. Again, some of them are great. Momentary Bliss is like one of the best Gorilla songs to drop in a while. But that's also heavily reliant on the features, and one song doesn't speak for the whole $250 box set. I don't know. Gorillaz has not been good since The Fall came out, that's all I'm gonna say. Please do not buy the Super Deluxe box set. They are milking it as hard as they can. Again, if you're gonna buy this as an LP, get the recycled Vinyl Me Please version. Rant over. I'll be talking about all the Joji stuff soon, probably. Peace.